with us on.
There you go. What a magnificent sight as the sun sets on the Gold Coast. Without a doubt, Australia's number one tourist destination. But it's never proved a happy hunting ground for the North Melbourne Giants. They take on the home side, the Gold Coast Rollers, tonight here at the Carrara Sporting Complex. Good evening and welcome. I'm Terry Kennedy. Well, it's been 5 long years since the North Melbourne Giants have tasted success here. Brian Curl joins me tonight. Will it be any different?
No, it's going to be very tough for the North Melbourne Giants. We know they're on top of the ladder and they've been playing very well. But so have the Gold Coast Rollers. And we know this has been a graveyard for a lot of top teams. Just ask the Melbourne Tigers.
Exactly. The Gold Coast Rollers knocking over the Melbourne Tigers here only a few weeks ago. One match played in the Mitsubishi Challenge last night. The Sydney Kings getting up over the Hobart Devils. So the Kings just keeping touch there, Curly.
Yeah, they are. And they struggled there for a few weeks, but they got back on track again. And that win will do them very well, even though it's only Hobart. And we can't underestimate Hobart. They are playing a lot better than they were early in the season.
The North Melbourne Giants, they travel here to Carrara, leading the Mitsubishi Challenge top eight. And they've been doing it in fine fashion throughout the season. The North Melbourne Giants have 11 wins and just 3 losses. They are coming off a loss, so no doubt, no complacency tonight.
They definitely won't. And just talking to Steve Breeny and one or two of the players before the game, they are very confident. They're playing very well, even though they had that loss last week. But Terry, those top five teams, not much separating them at all. And we see just in that top eight that the Gold Coast Rollers aren't there. So tonight's game for them is very important. You see there, they're just one game out of it. So a lot of pressure on them. We see the Illawarra Hawks, who have fallen out of favour now since Melvin Thomas was disqualified.
The Gold Coast Rollers are 8-8. Can they make it 9-8? We are about to find out. Coach Dave Claxton has made some changes to the Gold Coast Rollers starting five. Let's check the lineups as they stand at the moment. Andre Lafleur and Peter Hill in the guard positions for the Gold Coast Rollers. Mike Mitchell, Doug Peacock comes in the starting lineup for the Gold Coast Rollers, along with Tony D'Ambrosius, who is starting. They line up against Mark Leader, Darryl McDonald, one of the most exciting guards in the NBL, Johnson, Reedy, Sangstock. How do they line up, Curly?
Well, the Rollers have made some changes there. They're starting five, like I say, Doug Peacock. But have a look, Mitchell and D'Ambrosius are going to really have to do a bulk of the rebounding out there. The other three players, we know, they're not big rebounders. But the Giants aren't all that big either. When you look at Pat Reedy and Larry Sangstock, they're only their big players.
And for the benches, one of the best players in the NBL will be coming off the bench for the North Melbourne Giants. Paul Maley, the star import, has been suffering chronic back troubles. He's back and will play some vital minutes tonight. For the Gold Coast Rollers, Harvey Croker, Reese, Andrew Goodwin off the bench, and the big man, John Zaghetti. Zaghetti can do some damage off the bench. He's a player to watch when he does come on the court. A good crowd in here at the Carrara Sporting Complex to watch the league leaders, the North Melbourne Giants, do battle with the hometown favourites, obviously the Gold Coast Rollers. The Gold Coast Rollers, Curly, have only lost one game at home all season. They're very proud of their home court record, and what a big battle it should be tonight.
Yeah, that's correct, Terry. They play very well here, and a lot of teams come up here and don't give them the respect that they deserve. There we see Darryl McDonald. He's leading in the league in the MVP voting at the moment. Talking to Steve Breeny and a few of the players before the game. Have a look in there. From New York, 192 centimetres, 92. There's not too much of him out there. We're looking at his legs. I tell you what, I think he borrowed Leroy Loggins.
Chicken leg, yeah.
Yeah, but great player. Not a great... One thing about him, Terry, that makes him a very good player, that he thinks pass first, not shot. There are a lot of guards come out. They want to shoot the ball, then pass it. But Darryl McDonald... And the other thing that's very pleasing in the North Melbourne hierarchy is the fact that he does play defence.
John Zaghetti, as we mentioned, coming off the bench for the Gold Coast Rollers. But when he gets on court, always makes his presence felt. This young man, only 21 years of age, and you have big raps on him, Curly.
Well, I think he's got a lot of potential. He's just he's got to work hard at his game, especially his little jump shot there from about the 12, 15 foot area. But yeah, he tries hard, he bangs away, plays tough defence. And he's a goer, Terry, and I like anyone who has a go. And we look at the referees there. The old fella's back again, Eddie Crouch, Scotty Butler and Barry McLeod.
We're about to get underway. Mike Mitchell up against Larry Sangstock in the centre position. Reedy comes away with the ball. And straight away, Darryl McDonald wants the ball in his hands. Extremely tall for a guard in the NBL. Sangstock, the big recheck by Mike Mitchell. So Sangstock. Peter Hill, the North Melbourne Giants, who play predominantly a zone defence, has been very effective in season 1994. Can the Gold Coast Rollers bust the zone? McDonald runs the floor, a wayward pass. You see what he does. hold down second place in the league with assists. That one not quite coming in.
That's a bit unfortunate there, but he saw the open man coming down, but just passed a little bit in front. But a good rebound, a good outlet from Larry Senstock, which triggered off that fast break.
Lafleur now, who's been in good form for the Gold Coast Rollers. They enjoy playing at home. Mitchell can't do it from the baseline. What a battle this will be. Lafleur up against McDonald. Greedy breaks free, shoots, scores. First points of the night to Pat Greedy.
It's a nice jump around fadeaway there, Terry. Pat Reedy's playing very well in the Australian team now and playing with a lot of confidence, and he showed a lot of potential the last two or three years, and this could be his real big year.
Johnson goes out to meet Peter Hill. Tony D'Ambrosio, the ex-Sydney King. Peacock's not afraid to shoot the ball.
Mitchell stepped out of bounds down there. Not the turnovers, not the start of the game that the Rollers would like. And both teams a little bit scrappy, trying to feel each other out here. And you see both teams are coming off a loss. Neither team should have lost. Gold Coast should have beaten Canberra. And definitely North Melbourne shouldn't have beat the Illawarra Hawks. We'll see another basket there to Mark Leader.
And the assist coming from Darryl McDonald. Also played good defense on that occasion. Rod Johnson, Mike Mitchell, Andre Lafleur it was, with another block. Mitchell tries to work the baseline. Another turnover for the Gold Coast Rollers. So at the moment, the Gold Coast Rollers not putting enough pressure on the North Melbourne Giants. The Giants lead by 4 points to nil. Larry Sangston. Johnson steps past Lafleur. McDonald, good speed. Tall man there. Sangston knows he should have made that shot.
Sent to play McDonald. Penetrated there. Saw Larry Sangston just cutting into the keyway, and Sangston was close to the basket. Kept the ball up, drew the foul. And a great play there from Darryl McDonald. And the game's got to a slow start. Very scrappy start from both teams. The Rollers having a lot of trouble settling down.
Harry, it's never been his favourite place on the court, the charity stripe, shooting 61% over his career.
Well, you put the mocker on him, but you're right. But there's a great pass from him, though.
Johnson just went without the ball from Sangston. Doug Peacock, big night for him, starting in front of his home crowd here at the Carrara Sporting Complex. For 3 points, he can shoot the ball, Doug Peacock. Doesn't pay off on that occasion. Leader. And Peacock getting back with good speed at the other end of the court. Got right up there on Leader.
We're seeing the replay here. Peacock right up in his back, right over his shoulders. And Mark Leader will go to the line for two shots. No doubt about that foul there. It's a very easy one for the referees to call.
A coach wouldn't be too disappointed with that effort, though, from Peacock.
No, at least he got back. Like you said, he took the shot, missed it, but made great recovery there on defense. And at least made it tough for Leader. Wasn't going to give him two easy points. He had to earn them from the foul line.
Tony D'Ambrosius. Foul call on Pat Reedy.
It's an interesting one to watch on the replay there. I'm not quite sure if Pat Reedy had made position established. Tony D'Ambrosius, he was going to go all the way. He put his head down and he got the blocking foul called on Pat Reedy. So D'Ambrosius chance to make a 3-pointer. Oh, nobody shooting well from the foul line.
3 minutes gone in this game. North Melbourne Giants 6, the Gold Coast Rollers 2. The battle of the night. Lafleur up against McDonald. Greedy being double teamed. Gets a pass along the baseline. Leader takes that extra step towards the basket. Peter Hill did well in there.
North Melbourne share the ball around well, Terry. They're not selfish at all. There's always three or four passes in their offense.
Good play, the Gold Coast Rollers. They take their tally to four. Mike Mitchell scoring, 6 points to four. The Giants lead. McDonald. So eventually the North Melbourne Giants get the foul. McDonald.
Mitchell on his arm there, and McDonald was in there contesting that, Terry. He not have the big inches, but he gets in there and has a go.
McDonald, who's spearheaded the North Melbourne Giants to the top of the Mitsubishi Challenge ladder. What an import find he's been. At 30 years of age, making his debut in the NBL. Darryl McDonald, and making a hell of an impact. Hill thought about the three-pointer. See there, Darryl McDonald nearly had that steal there. He averages 4.6 steals a game, Curly.
Very good defensive player, and Rob McDonald wasn't too happy there with that foul being called on him, but this Darryl McDonald leading the league, like you say, he's an impressive player. He doesn't look all that flashy, just goes about his job, and very effective.
Flirt takes that extra step. Peacock now. So they're moving the ball around. The Rollers, but points are very hard to come by here at the moment. Nearly 5 minutes gone in this match, and it's only 7 points to four. 9 points to four. The Giants go further ahead.
Yeah, the Gold Coast Rollers left Rod Johnson open there, and not afraid to shoot.
D'Ambrosio couldn't make it. Mitchell. Good backup play by Mike Mitchell.
Terry, this had to be the two of the smallest starting lineups I've seen in the NBL for a long time out here. You've got Larry Senstock and Tony D'Ambrosio, two of the biggest.
Steal ones. By Peacock. Can he go all the way? Coast to coast, Peacock.
Great defensive play there from Peacock, and like you say, coast to coast, and finished off, and do the crowd like that, and so does Dave Claxton.
So now, just a one-point ball game. 9 points to eight. The Giants lead the Gold Coast Rollers. We were saying that Larry Sangstock used to be like the tallest player in the NBL, a real giant. And now, Curly, as you were mentioning,
what, 6'6" or something like that in the old, which I still work in. But out there, though, he's the big guy out there tonight. And it's very strange to see two teams in the NBL with this type of height. We know North Melbourne's got Paul Reece sitting on the bench.
McDonald can't do it. Reedy in there. Brett Brown, North Melbourne coach, has done so well with this side in 1994. Johnson over the top. Sangstock with a good rebound. And Peacock, well, he's doing his job in defense.
Well, he's earned his starting spot, and he's really justifying it now. Dave Claxton's giving the confidence, and we saw that great game he had the other week against the Melbourne Tigers, and Doug Peacock's just gone from strength to strength since then.
Peter Hill for 3 points, the pistol on target.
Never going to miss, was it? Never going to miss. Perfect shot. Great shot, as we see. Timeout being called.
Timeout called. The Gold Coast Rollers hit the front for the first time. 11 points to 9 over the North Melbourne Giants.
Starter. What do you need to be the best?
It's not always easy.
You have to work at it.
You're always pushing yourself to the limit.
I train every single day.
It's that rush you get when it all comes together.
Dedication.
Always giving it your best.
Discipline.
It's more than a dream for me to play league football.
It's fun playing in the NBL.
You're just all pumped up.
Starter.
What does it take to be the best? Everything you've got.
It's up to you.
Rimology by Shaquille O'Neal. The
engineers worked the numbers. They figured and refigured. They said it was indestructible. They said it was Shaq-proof. Maybe they should check their math.
Welcome back to Carrara. We're at the moment, we're midway through the opening quarter. The Gold Coast Rollers hold an 11.9 lead over the championship leaders in the North Melbourne Giants. Scrappy affair to start with, Brian Curl, but now things starting to settle down.
Yeah, especially for the Rollers. They're very scrappy at the start of the game there. And Dougie Peacock, he's played very well. Steal and a couple of rebounds. And a couple of shots have been made. That last three-pointer, Peters Hill, that was a real lift for the team. But yeah, they slow the game down. And Terry Bruce Palmer said in the media there last week or something that Gold Coast play a boring type of basketball. And that'll be interesting. Dave Craxton used that later on to motivate his team, but Gold Coast do, they really do slow the game down and take away that momentum from a lot of teams, and they rely on teams to make errors. And as long as they're shooting well, when they have their bad off nights in shooting, that's when they're going to get beaten. But tonight, so far, neither team's shooting very well. The Gold Coast at 50%, North Melbourne at 30% at this stage. So you've got that zone there that the Gold Coast Rollers are playing.
McDonald, the 3 points, couldn't make it. Brett Brown, the North Melbourne Giants coach, about to make some changes to his lineup. McDonald settles for 2 points and ties the ball game up. Paul Reese and Paul Maley about to check into the game for the North Melbourne Giants.
It's a fairly casual shot, that one. They just strolled in there, one leg, and put it up.
Tied up at 11 apiece. The starting five remain out there. The Gold Coast Rollers. Hill. Peacock inches closer to the basket. D'Ambrosius up there with a good aggressive rebound. Failed to make the shot. Peacock makes it. So Peacock, they really do love him here at the Carrara Roller Dome. Paul Reese comes on. What a season he's had. 1994 into the Boomers squad. The former Brisbane Bullet, you've got a lot of time for, Curly.
I have, Terry, and he's actually in the Australian team, and it's great to see, because Paul Reese, he's worked hard his game. Not an over-talented player, but plays well to his limitations, and great team man. Here he is. Come on, picked up a garbage shot straight away. And that's Paul Reese's game, and before you know it, he'll end up with 12, 14 points, and he'll get his rebounds, he'll have a go on defence. But he's all the time trying out there, and it's great to see him get rewarded in the Australian team, the World Championships, for all the hard work that he's done.
Also, his confidence must be just sky high at the moment. The North Melbourne Giants on top of the championship ladder. He's in the Australian team, and here goes Darryl McDonald. Pulls up for two.
That's really good defense there, good hands, and knew Andre Lafleur was breathing down his neck, but he just held up, and Lafleur knew there wasn't too much that he could do to stop him from scoring.
McDonald already. 5 points and another huge three for the Rollers. Andre Lafleur. They're back in front, 16 to 15. So the Rollers trying to break up the North Melbourne Giants zone from outside.
Well, Pat Reedy called there. He just dragged his back foot. Just lifted a little bit too soon, and he'll see it here. See that, Terry? Lifts his back foot before he puts the ball down, so call for travel. And it'd probably be better just get the ball moving a little bit at this stage. But you see this defensive zone's really working well here down here for North Melbourne. They played very well, and it's very interesting at the moment. I said to you before the game that the outcome between the McDonald and Fleur battle, I think, will determine who wins this game. And I still believe that, and it's good to see Andre Lafleur very offensive-minded.
Rollers showing good patience in offense. Lafleur for a big three. 20 rivers of two in a row for Andre Lafleur.
That was a big one. That was really as big as the one before it. And Andre Lafleur very on the ball tonight, that three-point shooting, and he's leading all scorers at this stage. And I said, when Andre Lafleur scores and he's in an offensive mind, that's when I think the Gold Coast Rollers look better.
left him alone. A near airball, just tipped the net. Reject by Mike Mitchell. McDonald, cool and calm. Stelter on court, can't do it. Great work by Andre Lafleur there. Knocked the ball out of McDonald's hands. Now, the roll will set up another offensive raid. Andre Lafleur, well aware of McDonald's reputation. Plenty of personal pride on the line out there tonight. Peacock, the rapid-fire three-pointer. Zaghetti on court for the Gold Coast Rollers.
It's John Zaghetti out there now, so he'll add a little bit more muscle. Don't they? Any height, but definitely had some muscle. So we have Paul Rees out there. He's the real giant. But that block down there of Mike Mitchell's, that was his second. So maybe that shaved head just giving a little bit of a few extra inches in elevation out there tonight.
Fleur steps, weaves. Stripped of the ball by McDonald. He rolls the ball from the side. Matthew Rees. He's coming off the bench. Obviously, he'll have a bit to prove out there tonight. Former Adelaide Super Sixers.
Been down a bit on form, Terry. You were saying, talking to Dave Paxton.
Not hugely. He just said he's come up with his starting lineup, obviously. Peacock doing a good job. Matthew Rees. Peacock again. Peter Hill.
That was from nearly the second row. A great pass. John Stelter there. Finished the layup on a great fast break there from the North Melbourne Giants. But what a great shot there from Peter Hill.
Peter Hill. Superbly. That's one way to break up the zone.
There's something new, Terry. The Gold Coast crowd have come to life a little bit early tonight. They're generally saving for the last 3 or 4 minutes. It was great to see. It adds a lot of atmosphere here to the Roller Dome.
Mitchell up there rebounding. Lafleur for three of his own. Can't do it. Now Matthew Rees. Good, strong offensive rebound. Plenty of big hits going in at the moment.
No room for the faint heart underneath the basket there tonight. That's great to see the referees letting that play. Let them play. Let them bang each other out there.
Great work by Paul Rees.
The big guy, Terry, I told you. He's got one assist and he's got 2 out of 2 already. That's a great look from the bench when you've got a player that can do that.
34 seconds remaining. Hill. Lafleur now. He's running the clock down. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. The Gold Coast Rollers. Hill's in form. He'd like to shoot the ball. He does shoot. 3 points. Basket counts. He's also drawn the foul. So Peter Hill doing a real job on the Giants.
So this could be a 4-point play, Terry. This is unbelievable. Letting him, he got the 3-point away. And Peter Hill, he's in great form tonight. 3 out of 3 from the 3-point range. And what about the Rollers? 5 out of 9. So there you are, 4-point play. So really give the Rollers a big boost now. And only 16 seconds going into the... before we go into the first, second quarter.
Peter Hill in the double figures for the Gold Coast Rollers with 10 points. Courtesy of 3 magnificent three-pointers. Paul Maley knocks down 3 of his own. Nothing wrong with a bad back on that occasion. Paul Maley with a great three-point shot at the end of the opening quarter. It is 26 the Gold Coast Rollers, 22 the North Melbourne Giants.
Okay, basketball fans, this is the one. Newcastle Hunters versus the Sydney Comets. The Hunters are keen to show Sydney what country basketball is all about. Get set, Newcastle, to see the Sydney Comets come crashing to earth this Saturday night at the Broadmeadow Basketball Stadium, courtesy of your team, the Newcastle Hunters. Tip off at 8 p.m. See the clash, the Newcastle Hunters versus Sydney Comets, sponsored by Anchor Seafood and NRTV.
The the Rollers, who have been on fire from outside in that opening quarter, to grab a 26-22 lead over the North Melbourne Giants. And after a bit of a scrappy start, Curly, this game has certainly come alive.
It's a few big three-pointers there. Gold Coast Rollers, 5 out of 9 from the three-point range, and that really brought things to life, especially the crowd. And with Dave Claxton, wasn't very happy there at the end of that quarter. I'd had a look at him after Paul Marley shot that one with a few seconds to go. So all the good work, really, and allowing Marley to get that three-pointer, really sort of undone a little bit. But the Gold Coast Rollers are really playing well. Mitchell, Lafleur, Peter Hill, and also Doug Peacock, who started. So very Brett Brown there, a young bloke, got a lot of potential as a coach and done a great job with his squad. And has really moulded them together, and interesting to see them leading the league, and they're worthy of leaders of the league, and it's good to see. Just like to know where he got that hairstyle from, Kerry. It reminds me of somebody else used to have one a few years ago.
Thought he would have learned. 26 the Gold Coast Rollers, 22 the North Melbourne Giants. Peter Hill and Paul Rees having a bit of a chat out there at the moment. They're about to get underway in this second quarter. Shrug of the shoulders from Mike Mitchell. Stelter gets the tip. Peter Hill's away. Hill scores. But Peter Hill, 12 points for the game so far. What a night out he's having here at the Carrara Rollerdome.
It's been a long time between drinks, though, Terry. Had a blinder here one night, and then the next two or three games he really struggled. But Stelter there with a turnaround jump and miss. But it's good to see Peter Hill back shooting the ball well, because if he shoots the ball well, and with Dougie Peacock shooting it well, and then you've got Lafleur, gives him a lot of outside score power.
McDonald, who had 5 points in that opening quarter. Maley finished off the quarter with a big three and starts the second quarter with another great shot from downtown.
Yeah, it's not very often, Terry, that you see somebody the size of Paul Maley. 201 centimetres, coming down, finishing the break and propping outside the three-point line and making that big three. So Maley's been a very valuable player in this North Melbourne lineup.
Missed a lot of matches this season with that chronic back problem. Came out and played 12 minutes last week and has opened up tonight as if that back is absolutely no trouble at all. McDonald dishes off to Darryl Pearce. Can't do it for three. Rebound, here we go. More points for Andre Lafleur.
Laid out the pass there from Mike Mitchell, and Lafleur and Hill were out leading the break, and Mike Mitchell saw them and threw it out, and good offensive there from the Gold Coast Rollers, so they're back into their zone. Matching up more now, to man-to-man.
Paul Maley wants this ball in his hand. Did a bit of everything there. Travel.
Only took about three or four steps, didn't he? But he knew it. A little bit of scrappy play there.
30 the Gold Coast Rollers, 25 the North Melbourne Giants. But if the championship leaders did come up here complacent, Curly, surely by now they must have it knocked out of them.
You'd think so. And
Rees, a good confidence boost for Matthew Rees, coming off the bench tonight. Scores 2 points.
As we see Maley, same stock coming on, and Stelter off, and so is Maley. So that's interesting. Maley's shooting well. We see Peter Harvey's coming on.
And John Zagetti.
Yeah, and we got Goodwin coming on.
Andrew Goodwin on. Oh, there's a bit of tall timber.
Yep.
Out there, Andrew Goodwin and Paul Rees. They'll go bumping at it. Pearce, Mark Leader. Bit of a push in the back there from Peter Harvey on Darryl McDonald. So the foul called against Peter Harvey.
Terry, there's two players in the NBL shooting 100% from the three-point line. Who do you reckon they'd be?
Thanks, Kerry.
Try Andrew Goodwin for one and Withers for Canberra the other. So two unlikely
one and
players.
One.
Probably had one shot each.
Leader. Line, 32-27, 5-point game. Mitchell, good strong work there by Mike Mitchell. He's come ready to play.
Certainly hasn't put that shot up, but Mark Leader's come from the on the weak side and tried to knock it away. Larry Senstock had good position there, but Mark Lee to call for the foul. So Mike Mitchell, like I say, he's having a very good game tonight. He's got 4 points already, 3 rebounds, 2 block shots, and they were 2 huge blocks that he had early in the game.
Mitchell takes his tally for the night along to 5 points. He's only had 5 shots. He's 2 from 5 in the field, and he's now 2 from 2 in the free throw line.
Full court press applied. Yeah. Customary, especially after they've made foul shot, they put that on, and works quite effective for them.
Pierce, good pass, kicked it back out to Mark Leader. Reese. Senstock in there, the veteran doing the hard yards.
Too tall in there, the recent Senstock. There's a
turnover. Pierce is away, should score and does.
Well, that was a bad turnover from Peter Harvey. That's not the type of play that Dave Faxon really would want to see. So it's only a 3-point lead now to the Rollers.
34-31, the Gold Coast Rollers. Up over the Giants. Harvey, Goodwin, kicked it back out to Matthew Reese, who just looks a touch out of sorts tonight, Matthew Reese. Failed to come off. McDonald in there makes amends. Now he travels back down court. He covers a lot of the court, Darryl McDonald. Saw Reese, great vision.
Was that a pass or was it? That was great vision. Great steal down the other end. Great anticipation. Took the ball up. Paul Reese cut underneath the basket. Darryl McDonald just giving the best pass you've ever seen. Have a look at it. Here it is. Everyone thinks he's going to shoot, but no. Gets up. Sees Paul Reese. And the big fella finishes off with a little layup underneath.
Peacock back on court now. Matthew Reese sits down. Harvey remains out there for the Gold Coast Rollers. Finds Goodwin. They're moving the ball around well. Peacock for three. As easy as you like. The hometown hero.
Well, you think that was easy, which it was. It was great ball movement, but poor transition. Getting back to cover Paul Reese. And I'd say Andrew Goodwin will get benched for that. That was poor transition, but it was great play down their offense from the Rollers, Terry. They moved the ball around, and Dougie Peacock left all alone.
Mitchell. Mitchell to Mark Leader in no uncertain turn. Goodwin showed good strength there.
Made the little basket inside there. Mark Leader called for the foul, the charging foul, but this wasn't called. And Brett Brown, he's asking the referees why. So a bit of frustration out there from players and coaches.
You're entitled to ask why, I imagine, Curly.
Yes, the referees are always right. They'll always give you the answer, but
doesn't do you any good, does it? The Gold Coast Rollers leading at the moment 39-35 over the Giants.
But can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
Well, Andre Lafleur, the captain, leading the way for the Gold Coast Rollers at the moment. 39-35 over the championship leaders, the North Melbourne Giants, who can't afford to make mistakes like that. Just having a look, the Gold Coast shooting a remarkable 55% three-point range, Brian Curl. I just wonder how much that has to do with assistant coach Ronnie Radnor, one of the great outside shooters in the NBL history. I know he does work hard with the players at training on their outside shooting, and for people like Peter Hill and Dougie Peacock, must be invaluable.
Well, you think if anybody knows anything about outside shooting, it's him, and he has done a lot of work with that. Oh, great play.
Mitchell.
Yeah, that was another good pass, Jerry. So certainly the guards out here turning on the show with some great assists. But yeah, you're right, Ronnie Radcliffe has put a lot of time into shooting with those guys, and who better could you get than Ronnie Radcliffe? The Rollers 6 from 11, 54% with the Giants, a woeful 2 from 7 with 28. So that's where the Rollers are in front at the moment. They're shooting so well from outside the 3-point line.
Paul Maley, the only player for the North Melbourne Giants, to make a shot from outside. Senstock makes one from inside the paint.
And Senstock wasn't happy with it after. I thought what he said, the referee, was quite interesting there. But he got the 2 points, and just got to get on and play.
Mitchell on the baseline. Good rebound by Leader.
He's been great service to the game in North Melbourne over the years, Terry. A very good player and very smart, very heady. It does a great job for them.
277 NBL games. They can boast some experience. This North Melbourne Giants, Mark Leader, draws the foul. So 277 games for Mark Leader. What about Larry Sangstrom? 381.
Like you say, obviously there's this foul here. Yeah, just a little bit of body there, a little bit of pushing, and Mark Leader was fouled before he was in the act of shooting, so it was side ball. But yeah, Sangstrom throw in Darryl Pierce. He's played a few games as well. And Maley's no spring chicken, and nor is this guy shooting the ball now. So they've got experience galore. And there's one of the good young up-and-coming players in Pat Reedy. So they've got a good blend out there of experience and youth, North Melbourne Giants.
A lazy 326 games for Darryl Pierce. Just missed that opportunity, the North Melbourne Giants. Tony D. Roses comes over. Coming on court very shortly. Lafleur slips, but still managed to get back up and play on. Can he go around? Would have been a great play.
Just got caught up there a little bit and couldn't dish it off, but good defense from the North Melbourne Giants. The Rollers back into defense here as we see the battle still going on between McDonald and Lafleur.
Reedy. Been in good form for the Boomers, and in training camp, Pat Reedy. Johnson for 2 points. Peter Hill checks back into the game. Peter Harvey will have a rest, while Tony D'Ambrosius comes on for Andrew Goodwin. We're calling the shots now for the Gold Coast Rollers. We have a tied up ball game. 41 points apiece. Lafleur changes all that with ease.
Great play, great cut off the high post there from Andre Lafleur. He broke the deadlock there. So Andre Lafleur is having a very good game tonight.
Mitchell steals the ball off Reedy, only just need to go out of bounds. Now Paul Reese checks back in. Larry Sangstrom.
It's not bad when you take off a former Australian player, a triple Olympian in Larry Sangstrom, and bring on a new Australian player in Paul Reese. It's a great luxury to have.
Rod Johnson can't make it go down. Reese can't either. D'Ambrosius with a defensive rebound. We've just robbed Larry Sangstrom of one Olympic Games there, Curling, and we better...
Four of them, was it, Ollie?
Four Olympics and four World Championships.
Yeah, it's been a great... Here's McDonald. Makes a great steal here. Tremendous hands. Goes in. Lafleur's all over him here. Grabs him. So McDonald's foul. But I apologise there to Larry Sangstrom. Four. And what a great ambassador and a great service he's done to his country playing in all those Olympics. And I remember back in 1980 in the Moscow Olympics, and all the trouble was on. He came to me and asked me my thoughts, should he go? And my quick reply was, I said, yes, go. I said, let the politicians fight that in the parliament and all that. I said, they shouldn't be using sportsmen, and I still believe that. And Larry Sangstrom and Danny Morsu, they went to Moscow in their first Olympics, and that's what you train and play for, to represent your country, and nothing should be able to rob you of that. And Larry Sangstrom, he looks back, probably really glad that he did go, because four Olympic Games, one Olympic Games is great, but when you can play four, it's a fantastic effort.
Fantastic career it has been for Larry Sangstrom, and it's not over yet, Curly, either.
No.
Still probably playing some of the best basketball he's played in season 1994. It really helps when you're in a winning team, a team that's winning, and your confidence is up there, you're playing good minutes.
Yeah, well, he was disappointing last year, and he was disappointed in the way he played, and did a lot of work pre-season, and has trained very hard, and got a few of his priorities in order, which is good to see. And like I say, he's playing just as good as he has in the last 4 or 5 years, and he keeps playing like this, he could play for another 2 or 3, because Larry, he's looking
after his body. Mitchell.
That's his third. This guy's got great anticipation.
He cleans up Scotty Butler as well.
What sort of dance that is.
It's amazing to see Darren McDonald warm up before the game. He actually warms up with the headset on, listening to the music. Very cool and calm customer at 30 years of age. Darren McDonald really does explode once that whistle goes. Hill looking to break the deadlock is Andre Lafleur. McDonald goes around Lafleur, then McDonald around his back. Would have been a sensational basket. Paul Reese scores and draws the foul.
Terry, Paul Reese has had 5 rebounds and 10 points. Here it is. Here, look at this McDonald. He just throws this ball up. It was a bit of a hope shot there. Paul Reese gets it, keeps the ball up, keeps it above his head. A lot of work with him in that area there, and so is Brett, his coach now, and Paul Reese being a big bonus there for them. He's, like I said, it's 11 points. He's hit 5 out of 8, 62% from the field, and taken 5 rebounds. That's a huge lift and a great bonus for any team or player to come off the bench and do that for it.
Nice bench play.
Great bench play.
Mike Mitchell. Lafleur. 2 minutes remaining in the second quarter. 46 the Giants, 43 the Rollers.
So where is for the Rollers, Terry? Nobody's come off the bench and really given them a lift at all. Sagetti, Goodwin, Matthew Reese. None of those players have given a lift that they really need.
The Ambrosius on the line for the Gold Coast Rollers. Started this game for the Rollers and makes the first of the free throws. Take his tally for the night along to 3. The full court pressure being applied by the Rollers. Hill there, Lafleur down court to meet Pat Reedy. Now McDonald just uses his speed. Mitchell, can he grab the ball? Can't do it. Forced the turnover though. That's the sort of aggressive play the Gold Coast Rollers need coming up to this halftime break. Now they set up their zone. The North Melbourne Giants. One-point ball game. Lafleur can't do it. Reese picks up another rebound. Donald, he wants the ball in his hands. Controls the show with great power he does. Mailing. Desperate play by the big man. Reedy, that step closer. Can't do it off the backboard.
That man Reese again, Terry. Up there, gets the rebound, foul. That's to the foul line for 2 more, so. Here it is, the rebound's up there. Big hands, big strong hands from the big guy. And this foul from behind there. And Paul Reese, had a great game from the bench.
Paul Reese has been averaging 6 points a game over his career already. He has 11 points tonight. He can't make it 12. He will get a second chance at it. Interesting to note, though, in season 1994, he's been averaging 22 points. That just proves how his form has lifted. 1994. We're into the final minute before the halftime break. The Giants 47, the Rollers 45, and a big call there of travel. Goes against the Gold Coast Rollers. Rollers trying to maintain the pressure up to the halftime break. Donald kicks it to Leader. Leader hurts the Rollers with a three-point play. 5 points now. The split to the North Melbourne Giants. Mitchell trying to get away from Pat Reedy. That's not an easy task. Rob Croker out there in singlet number 6 for the Rollers. Hill. Been in great form. Here goes McDonald. What will he do?
Well, he'll go up and slam it 2 hands, as casual as you like. And we see he's averaging about 4.6 steals. And that's his 4th one for the game tonight. And he's been a... this guy, he made it so easy. He's so casual looking the way he plays.
Once again, the Rollers just losing their grip up to the half-time break. Tony D'Ambrosi gets them 2 points closer.
Oh!
What a Hail Mary shot that was! Unfortunately for the Giants, it won't count, but I'm sure it'll make the highlights real. Fantastic stuff to finish off this halftime break. The Giants 52, the Rollers 47. Welcome back to the Carrara Sporting Complex. At the moment, the championship leaders, the North Melbourne Giants, 52, lead the Gold Coast Rollers, 47. What a second half we are in for here at the moment. The Rollers who led at quarter time. Now Trail had their starting five back on court. D'Ambrosius can't make the first shot of the second half.
The second quarter, Terry, was a 30-point quarter for the North Melbourne Giants, whereas the Rollers could only manage 21. So the momentum just swung the North Melbourne Giants way, and it's an interesting tussle here. Both teams, same as the start of the game, they both teams off to a tender start with some little errors there.
Peacock for three. This will bring the crowd alive. It won't go down. Once again, McDonald away. Johnson being quiet in the opening half, Rob Johnson. Fleur waits for the troops to arrive. They come in the form of Mitchell. Fade away for two. Can't go down. Johnson. Pat Reedy. He's yet to cut loose as well on the scoreboard. Plenty of firepower out there for the North Melbourne Giants leader. Great score, but what a great assist by
classic,
Pat Reedy.
The classic backdoor play there, Terry. Mark Leader just led his defensive player up, got a step on him, backdoor to the basket, and a super pass there from Pat Reedy.
54 the Giants, 47 the Rollers. They don't want to give away too big a break. Once again, that man McDonald, Curley, he's everywhere, spoiling many, many offensive plays for the Gold Coast Rollers.
Yeah, well, he's been credited now with five steals for the game, and he's just got uncanny anticipation. He just seems to read the game so well, where the ball's going to be. He didn't read it too well then, but, you know,
So once again, LeFleur answering the challenge. It's still fairly much even Stevens at the moment between the battle between McDonald and LeFleur. Peacock pulls it up. There's been plenty of turnovers from both sides at the moment. 12 to the Rollers, the Giants 10. I guess any turnovers too many, Curly.
It is, yeah, and it's a little bit too many at this stage. Both coaches wouldn't be too happy.
Can't do it off the backboard, Andre LeFleur. So in the first 2.5 minutes of this third quarter, the Gold Coast Rollers are yet to score. North Melbourne Giants, 54. Up over the Rollers, 56, make it courtesy of Larry Sangstock, who brings up 6 points for the night so far. Sangstock needs 13 points to bring up 5,000 points in the NBL. What a magnificent milestone that would be. Peter Hill for three! Gets the Gold Coast Rollers going.
That's his fourth one for the night. 4 out of 5 3-pointers. And he's game high now with 15 points. And having a sensational game for the 3-point line is Peter Hill.
Peter Hill goes to 15 points. Andre LeFleur has 10 points for the Gold Coast Rollers. Only two players in double figures for the North Melbourne Giants. That is Leader with 11 and Paul Reese with 12. Paul Maley takes his tally along to 8 points.
Pretty good in it, Paul Reese and Paul Maley between them have scored 20 points off the bench, so that's a real bonus for the North Melbourne Giants, and both these players have, you know, Paul Maley hasn't been playing that much lately, he's been out injured. There's a great basket there from Andre LeFleur.
Reedy. Now, the Rollers running the ball. Hill wants it for 3 points. Can he do it? was in and popped back out. McDonald runs now. Just lost touch of control there. Darren McDonald, and the call goes against Tony D'Ambrosius. The foul called by Eddie Crouch. The crowd's booing it. Won't worry, Eddie Crouch. One iota.
Now here we see it here. As the booing has stopped, but Daryl Johnson gone in there, and D'Ambrosius has got him on the arm, but great outlet pass from Larry Sandstock. Big rebound, outlet the pass, and Daryl Johnson just took it at D'Ambrosius. McDonald. And just too smart there, and drew the foul, and gets two shots.
McDonald on the charity stripe at the moment. Makes both. They all count and they all hurt. Full court pressure being applied by the North Melbourne Giants. Now they drop back. Johnson goes there to try and stop Lafleur. 8-point buffer at the moment to the Giants. Starting to settle down and sort of take control of momentum. D'Ambrosius, double team, kicks it back out. No way through. Good defense by the North Melbourne Giants.
There's 2 seconds left on the shot clock, so Gold Coast Roll's going to have to run something special here to get it in. So get it in the hands of Lafleur or Hill to try and get the shot away. And there it is, it's a steal already.
Once again, McDonald the man. That's being triple team. That's going to leave people open for the North Melbourne Giants. Maley, charge foul. Tony D'Ambrosius stood his ground. What an awesome sight it must have been. Big Paul Maley coming at you. Here it is.
Yep.
D'Ambrosius had position.
There's no doubt about the foul. And Paul Maley, he went in strong. He wasn't going to hold back at all. And good defense there from D'Ambrosius.
Not exactly easing his bad back into this game, is he, Paul Maley? The moment he came on, the floor does it for big 3 points.
And turned around and had something to say to McDonald after.
What a great battle it's been. It hasn't been a winner yet. Long way to go in this game. 5-point ball game. Backdoor play. Johnson, now the intensity starting to pick up a bit on defense. Peter Hill in a good show. Sportsmanship there goes and helps Johnson to his feet.
So Larry Sandstock's left the game. Paul Roos coming back on. So Larry Sandstock having a very serviceable game, and so's Paul Roos. Terry should take this opportunity while at the foul on here. Rod Johnson, young Jason Kinnersley from Grafton, is a real keen Rollers fan. It's his 17th birthday on Sunday, and the Rollers wish him well.
Jason Kinnersley is hoping to celebrate tonight with a Gold Coast Rollers victory. And there's a packed house in here at the Roller Dome. He's cheering with you, Jason. At the moment, the Gold Coast Rollers trail by 7 points. They're finding it hard to narrow this gap. The intensity has certainly picked up for both teams. The big looping shot by D'Ambrosius won't count. Turn around, jumper, Mitchell!
Well, it's been a while since Mike Mitchell scored, and it's a timely one there. It was a big rebound, and held up there, and got. And Pat Reed is bleeding profusely there from the eye. A little bit of Rocky coming in the game here.
Saying the intensity has picked up, there's no doubt about it. There's been some big hits going in there. Obviously cuts near the eye do cut easily and bleed profusely.
They certainly do, and had a few, but
I've got a few marks on your face. Yeah. I thought you your zippers there, I thought you'd know all about it.
Yeah, well, the plastic surgeon couldn't help it, some of them either, but
Pat, money back.
he got a nasty one there, and that's the thing. You get these big guys underneath the basket banging away. It always amazes me, these people say that basketball's a soft game, but I tell you what, I'd defy anyone to get on that basket. You get a couple of 6'8", 6'10" guys banging away with those elbows, and they can become quite lethal. Nothing intentional, nothing deliberate, but it just happens, it's just accidents.
So there's been some good hits out there. Plenty of action under the basket. The tall timber in both teams going to work. McDonald, that is a great assist by McDonald. Thank you. Curly, I saw a piece during the week, last weekend, the American saying what really makes a great basketballer is vision. Not very many people have the vision on the basketball court. I think you're seeing the vision of Darryl McDonald tonight.
Well, I think you've got two out there that are just first class in that area. There's another big three-pointer there from Rod Johnson. In Andre Lafleur, don't take him away. He's got great vision of the court also, and so is Darryl McDonald. Two brilliant players, classic players, and when you've got a point guard with vision like that, even big guys, you need the centre to have good vision also. So when the point guard can penetrate, see, oh, there he goes for the steal again. But both players out here, and you're right, look at that vision, it makes so much difference.
I guess when you speak of vision, you really speak of Magic Johnson.
Well, yeah, I think he had extra vision. He just had that little bit extra out there, and not often you see somebody 6'8", 6'9".
What a great player he was over many a long year. The North Melbourne Giants at the moment 67, the Gold Coast Rollers 59. Welcome back to the Carrara Sporting Complex. The Giants 67, the Rollers 59. A real battle royale in this third quarter. We're midway through it. McDonald's away again. Lafleur comes at him. Mailey from outside for three.
Well, that was another good steal there from Darryl McDonald. Brilliant steal. And Paul Mailey once more finishing off the break from outside the three-point line.
Mitchell. Lafleur. Andrew Goodwin's out there for the Gold Coast Rollers. D'Ambrosius out of the game at the moment. Peacock's played well. Mitchell scores an easy two. Nice assist.
Good offense there. Moved the ball around. Mike Mitchell had his defensive player on his back, and when he got it, it was very hard to stop inside the keyway. Mike Mitchell. The Giants, they're leading 17-8 on the defensive board. So just shows you the Rollers' shooting percentage. Well, they're shooting 50%, but that's good rebounding there from the Giants.
Mailey's in good touch, can't do it on that occasion. McDonald is not letting his eyes leave Andre Lafleur. Here they go, Lafleur with the ball. McDonald right on him, the screen set by Goodwin. Goodwin under the basket, makes the two.
Look there from Mike Mitchell. Andrew Goodwin just left alone a little bit there, and he had the height, threw the ball up, and we have the defensive player to be able to stop him. And Senstock comes in for Paul Mailey.
A lot of rest for Larry Senstock tonight. That's the way he likes it, playing plenty of minutes. Johnson and McDonald, the top of the keyway, lead up. Mitchell's away. The Rollers are running the ball. Hill works the baseline to perfection. Can't make the basket.
Good defense there from North Melbourne Giants. So Peter Hill driving the keyway. You have too far to go because three guys, here it is here, look at this. Three defensive players in there. Swarmed all over Peter Hill, and Larry Senstock pulled down the rebound and was fouled in the process. Still playing that zone defense, Terry. North Melbourne trying to probe, get that inside. Haven't got their best outside shooting team on at the moment.
Mailey on the bench at the moment. Johnson works his way through. McDonald. Leader can shoot from outside. That was an air ball on that occasion, which fell into the hands of Paul Reece, who made the easiest of baskets.
Well, Croker fouled him. He just racked him on the arm, was laughing all the way down the court. Nothing was cool. Made Mark Leader look bad with an air ball, but he probably put it down to assist of his playing
right,
after
probably
the game.
Probably say it's a set play.
Yeah.
McDonald's away and running.
This Darryl McDonald, another steal. That gives him six for the game now. And,
Coach Dave Claxton there trying to rally his team. They trail by nine and they just haven't really been able to narrow that gap in this third quarter. Scoring's been tough for the Rolls. Johnson, McDonald. Great play, the Giants working the ball around to perfection.
See what they did, they worked it over here, the strong side ball, and then Mark Leader just flashed in from the weak side down. It was a great defensive play from Senstock. Oh.
Reject by Goodwin. Paul Reese there. Pick up the scraps.
Terry, you saw three great plays there. McDonald's pass was a brilliant pass. Then you saw Andrew Goodwin, the big block on the backboard, and a great follow-up there from Paul Reese. They're very good basketball there.
13 points now, the split to the North Melbourne Giants. Coach Dave Claxton would have to be feeling a bit desperate at the moment. Looking to his bench, looking to make a couple of changes. Things have got to happen for the Gold Coast Rollers. Johnson. They're looking sharp now, the North Melbourne Giants, just the way they're moving this ball around. Johnson can't do it. Croker up there, picks off the rebound. They need to score on this trip down court. Keeping possession of the ball is the hard thing. Mitchell for three at the top of the key.
We'll play once more from Andre Lafleur. Drove off the screen and then kicked the ball back to Mitchell, who was open at the three-point line. And Mike Mitchell did the rest. And we see Matthew Reese come back in for Crocus. So Dave Claxton searching out there. And his rollers, somebody's got to make things happen out there. Maybe it's Mike Mitchell.
So Darryl Pierce comes on, makes his presence felt straight away. 79-66. Still 13 points, 1 minute and 15 seconds remaining. Mitchell and Lafleur have to try and make something happen for the Rollers. Reese on court for three, does it off the bench. Matthew Reese.
Well, that gives 10 three-pointers to the Rollers tonight. If one part of their game that's keeping them in the game has been their three-point shooting, and
56%, 10 from 18, Curly.
It's not bad shooting, is it? And they're not afraid to put them up.
It's not too shabby from the North Melbourne Giants from outside either. 6 from 14 at 43.
Yeah, well, they picked it up a little bit there. It wasn't too good in the first half, but we see the three-point shooting there. 10 from 18, 55% for the Rollers. That's very good shooting, and the Giants 6 from 14 for 42. Not too bad. Some great outside shooting here, and the Gold Coast Rollers, like I said, we've got Lafleur, Hill and Peacock, who are all very good shooters from that three-point line.
Paul Reese on the line for the North Melbourne Giants. Can't do it. One-on-one's the call. Reese. The Rollers just, over keen on that occasion, getting inside the keyway. Won't go down.
Goodwin knocked it away from the ring.
Big play by Mitchell. So, bit of desperation keeping into the Rollers' play. Goodwin thought he was going to score that accident. Lafleur, fake, three, couldn't do it. 10-point ball game. Can the Rollers pull out a defensive stop?
The big 6'10" guy there dribbling the ball down and got his head up and tried to hit Mark Leader, but Paul Reese, he was a bit of a point guard there for a while.
That's confidence. Tried to bounce the ball off the feet of Lafleur. It didn't pay off for the Giants. Could be a vital play. Just before three-quarter time, 20 seconds remaining. Lafleur being double-teamed. Mitchell is free. He wants the ball. Goodwin looks like he's going alone. Blocked by Larry Sengstock. Pierce. 6 seconds left on the clock. Looking to spread the ball. Oh! A bad slide there for Lafleur.
Well, that clock should have stopped. Well, it should have stopped a couple of seconds ago because it'll be a one-on-one situation here with Darryl McDonald. Here you see it here, like Lafleur's reached in, foul's being called there. So Darryl McDonald will be a one-on-one situation.
The North Melbourne Giants, mark leader 13, Darryl McDonald 11, Rod Johnson 12, Paul Maley 10, and Paul Reese 16, Pat Reedy. At the moment, not fantastic, but stop leading, I'm sure he'll take a major role in this final quarter. But at the moment, McDonald just waits as the clock's being reset to try and stretch this 10-point advantage for the North Melbourne Giants. He's made 5 from 6 tonight, Carroll McDonald. Make that. 5 from 7. The Hail Mary! It counts! What a huge basket! Andre Lafleur has brought the house down here at the Roller Dome. That could be a clutch basket, a vital play for the Gold Coast Rollers. And it's certainly set up an exciting final quarter here. Lafleur, 79 the North Melbourne Giants, 72 the Rollers.
Mitsubishi dealers are putting the crunch on prices, so score yourself a great deal now.
It's crunch time coming at you.
What a Hail Mary it was from Andre Lafleur to have the Gold Coast Rollers trailing the North Melbourne Giants by just 7 points going into this final quarter. And the North Melbourne Giants, they weren't too happy about that shot from Andre Lafleur counting right on the three-quarter time buzzer. They realised just how vital that could be coming down to the money end of this game. But I don't know. It was close.
Well, that was close.
Well, worthy of a magnificent basket.
Yeah, well, it brought the crowd alive, and it might be the shot that the Rollers need to lift there. But that one was close, and so was the one at halftime that McDonald put up, and which was disallowed.
Andrew Goodman flew high there for a good defensive rebound to show he means business in this final quarter. It's amazing how a shot like that can really spur a team on, especially going into a three-quarter time break, Curly.
Yes, and it was a big lift. Here's Mike Mitchell banging away inside there. So once more, the game's off to a scrappy start. It'll be interesting to see. You know, the Rollers, they need a lift. And here's Andrew Goodwin. He's starting now. So Doug Peacock started the first quarter, but here we go. Oh, poor Reese.
Found Larry Sengstock, who was also his captain from the Brisbane Bullets.
It wasn't the most delicate move or elegant move of Paul Reese.
It wasn't graceful, was it? But at least they don't draw diagrams. It's good. It's interesting. You call Tim, Paul Reese. Goodwin uses good speed. That's a big move by Andrew Goodwin.
Left-hander there, and he went in strong. And this Paul Reese was flying down the other end. Misses, and a basket will be counted because there was interference there. So Paul Reese replied to it. And Gold Coast has been caught out a few times tonight in their transition play.
6 points for Andrew Goodwin so far tonight. He only needs two more, Curly, to chalk up his first 1,000 points in the NBL.
That'll be a good milestone for him. Going back to Paul Reese, it's great to see a big guy like 6'10 running the floor, leading the break, getting down there, and it causes defences a lot of problems.
Coached well in the early days, obviously.
Well, the one thing about Paul Rees is he loves the game and he listens. And let's hope now that he's made the Australian team that he keeps listening, because he's still got a lot to learn, and he's going to develop in the next 2 or 3 years. We always said he would be a slow developer because of his size, and he needed to build up his upper body. He wasn't strong in his upper body when he came to Bullets in the early days. He's got very strong up there and build up, and that's what will make him a better player. And he will look at him in another 2 or 3 years' time. If he keeps improving, he's going to be a real dominant player in the NBL.
That's 999 career points for Andrew Goodwin. He is just 1 point away from cracking that 1,000-point milestone. Brian Kerr mentioned what a big boost for him it would be. Pierce couldn't do it with the rapid-fire three-pointer. Pat Reedy out there with a bad cut in front of his eye. Continues to score the North Melbourne Giants, and they hold a 10-point advantage. Plenty of time left in this game. 9 minutes and 50 seconds. Peter Hill can change all that. He does make it a 7-point ball game with the pistol. Peter Hill at his very best here tonight, Brian Curl.
5 out of 7 three-pointers, 71% from the three-point line. I agree, he's having a great night in that three-point line. And scoring overall, Peter Hill has been a real bonus for them.
The Fleur, they'd like to keep the ball in Peter Hill's hands outside if they possibly could. But he's going to be paid a lot of attention by Darryl Pearce. Andrew Goodwin's shot was in, then popped back out.
I'm down in there.
78 the Rollers, the Giants 85. Reedy looked to get the ball inside the Pearce, couldn't do so. Rollers. Great ball movement.
Well, there's no doubt about that. The crowd's got nothing to complain about. Dave Flaxton, he'd be disappointed in that, because that was an easy basket there from Matthew Rees. Have a look here. Great pass. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, well, got us 1, 2, lay the ball up. So Matthew Rees called for the travel, and that was probably not the easiest call of the night for the referees, but I think it'll be about the second easiest call for the night.
Big play. That was a big play for the Gold Coast Rollers. They ran it well.
Yeah.
Not to come up with the 2 points hurts.
A little bit of a problem there with Pat Reedy and the referees, but Pat Reedy's still on. But that was inexcusable. That Matthew Rees had all the time in the world. He could have just taken one bounce and up strong. But great look, great pass there from Mike Mitchell, but to no avail.
It's time. Foul called. Donald, Andre Lafleur will take the foul call, and McDonald will go to the line. 4 fouls for Andre Lafleur. 8 minutes 45, I guess, just getting into that danger zone a touch. He's had a great game, Andre Lafleur. A bit more blood for Pat Reedy, just not being able to.
It's just weeping from underneath the band-aid, so Dr. Physio there will clean it up a little bit. Stick a bit of gum around it, stop the blood from oozing out, and get him back in there to play again.
Donald, now the crowd has come alive a bit here, Brian Curl, as you mentioned. The fourth quarter, they get a bit revved up.
Well, I suppose
they enjoyed that Hail Mary, didn't they?
Well,
three quarter time.
If that doesn't liven you up, nothing will. That was a sensational shot. But they were pretty enthusiastic at the start of the game, and then they must have went for a walk, and they're back again now, so it's good to see.
We're in for a great finish here at the Carrara Sporting Complex on the Gold Coast. The Rollers doing battle with the championship leaders. Paul Maley, the foul. His third foul for Paul Maley. He's getting hands on here on Mike Mitchell. Plenty of body.
Mike Mitchell just got that half a step in front of him there, and Paul Maley is a little bit slow defensively to adjust.
Mitchell. Good pass by Andre Lafleur. That man, McDonald. Maley, he's thought long and hard about the three-point attempt. Plenty of time, the screen set by Big Paul Rees. And they came from everywhere at Rod Johnson, but Reece was there.
He certainly did, but you were talking about vision before. What about that vision there of McDonald? We saw Rod Johnson open underneath and Paul Reece once more there to pick up the garbage points, and that gives him 18 points and 11 rebounds for the game.
Fleur drives to the basket.
See McDonald there, he acknowledged that was poor defense on his part then. He tried to go for the steal from behind and let LeFleur get in there and penetrate. And he did acknowledge to the coaches that it was his fault. It was a good one leave the court. Dean Braces is on. LeFleur.
The big looping free throw goes down, so that makes it 21 points, a game high. Andre LeFleur at the moment. Can he do 22? Yes. So the Gold Coast Rollers captain, as he normally does, leading from the front in both offense and defense. A big assignment for him tonight, containing Darryl McDonald. Great work by Mike Mitchell. He just couldn't control the ball at that vital stage. He deserved better.
Certainly did, and he was very unfortunate there, and Paul Maley came up with the ball and finished up a little jump shot, but good hustle there from Mike Mitchell, but as we said, wasn't rewarded.
Hill, he's thinking about that big three. Johnson had a good hold on him. Reece, Paul Maley. Flew in there, the ball was up there, was up for grabs for a while, and Maley just came in. And Mitchell doing his best to pickpocket that ball. Johnson, Reece. Paul Reece continues to hurt the Gold Coast Rollers. Takes his tally to 20 for the night so far. It's a big effort off the bench. In fact, he leads. The leading scorer is for North Melbourne Giants with 20. And 6.5 minutes left. It's 80 the Gold Coast Rollers. They trail the North Melbourne Giants 93. Welcome back to the Carrara Sporting Complex. It's a 13-point ball game. 6 minutes and 25 seconds left before full time. The Giants 93, the Rollers 80. Big plays about to happen. We get down to the real money time here. The Ambrosius goes without it, draws the foul. Rod Johnson puts up his hand and claims it.
Foul on Rod Johnson, second personal foul.
And Dean Ambrosius goes to the line for the Gold Coast Rollers. And Dean Ambrosius shooting 58% over his career from the free throw. Makes a nice looping shot on that occasion. He's certainly improved his free throw shooting. Season 1994. Six minutes remaining in this final quarter. An 11-point break. This is all going to change. Mitchell dunks the ball. Brett Brown on his feet. He wanted the travel call. Wanted the travel called on Mike Mitchell. He took a couple of real big hops. Went up there and really slammed that ball away. So Mitchell might well finish with a flurry here. He has 17 points at the moment, 7 from 13 from the field.
It's a big steal, one of a great steal. Travel or not, what a basket. It's brought the crowd alive. They're chanting Rollers. And now there's a turnover there. The North Melbourne Giants get it back, but the game's finally come alive, Terry, and we could be in for a great finish here.
Turnover.
Need to call a timeout, Brett Brown. Forget about the referees. Call a timeout. Settle things down. Settle the crowd down and get control once more.
Players are all fired up now. 19
13 turnovers to the Gold Coast Rollers, far too many. The North Melbourne Giants 17. Peter Hill scores. The Rollers are on their way back here at Carrara.
Well, Peter Hill, he's brought his shooting arm tonight, and well, he's having a great game, and this crowd, they've really come alive now, and it's great to see.
Johnson can't do it from outside. Leader pulled down, absolutely vital. Rebound. Now, there was not a lot of purpose in that. Paul Reese has given Tony D'Ambrosius a huge mouthful.
Well, there's no doubt that bell there, is it? Yeah, you give him a real mouthful, didn't he? Just let him know a few things.
Mouth guard and all.
Mouth guard and all.
It's great this bit has so pumped up. We go down to the wire with 4 minutes and 39 seconds remaining. 93 to 86. Reedy on there for 14. Don't forget the Rollers have only lost one game at home this season. They're proud of that record. Hill running, gives the ball to Pat Reedy. He thought it was Doug Peacock. Reese, the big man, can't score. Mitchell's in there, grabbing the rebound. Away he comes. 7-point ball game. The intensity is certainly picked up here.
Well, how unlucky is that, Terry? Last two times down, Peter Hill was unfortunate. Had a classic three-on-one situation. Threw the ball away, and then Mike Mitchell just misread it. Andre Lafleur had the backdoor play, was just held up. And Mitchell thought he was gone, but the ball went astray. So it's unfortunate for the Rollers. A basket there would have made this very interesting.
McDonald had the shot, but dished off instead. Mitchell's done a magnificent job there to steal the ball. Peacock, Lafleur wanted it. Lafleur trying to get himself free now, trying to get away from Mark Leader. Hill, open. Only for a moment, though. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. He goes for a massive bomb. Had Andre Lafleur there in support.
He's probably not the right option, and Andre Lafleur knows it. And so is Dave Faxon, and not happy at all. Just said a few words there to Peter Hill. But that's happened. They've got to get back. They need to stop down the defensive end now. They'll try and come down and just get this down to 4 or 5 points.
Reedy drives under the basket, made a big strong basket. No foul was the call. And that shot from Peter Hill did come off, though. He was a hero. It's one of those situations, isn't it?
It is, but you've got to go for the percentages as well, and especially the situation of the game at the moment. But oh, that was a big basket of Pat Reedy's for reverse layup.
9 points in this game. Lafleur. Oh. D'Ambrosius, great work, Andre Lafleur. What an assist.
Poor adjustment on defense there from North Melbourne. They didn't come across the weak side and just clogged that middle up, and D'Ambrosius left unattended inside.
Leader now. Time favors the North Melbourne Giants with 2 minutes and 20 seconds left. This battle between McDonald and Lafleur going right down to the wire. Both players clearly have 8 assists.
Here we see it here. He really put the hammer down here, Darryl McDonald. But Andre Lafleur just pushed him with his body there and drew the foul. And that's 5 fouls now on Andre Lafleur.
Both players have 5 assists, as I mentioned, Lafleur and McDonald. Lafleur has 22 points. McDonald has 13. So it's been a big effort. McDonald has 7 steals. So it's been a big effort by him.
Look at the one blemish on his game, Terry, is the 7 turnovers that he's had. Andre Lafleur's only had 3, so I think on the stats you'd have to probably give the points there to Andre Lafleur, wouldn't it?
Certainly been a battle which will continue to rage on in this final 2 minutes and 16 seconds. Coach Dave Claxton remaining calm in this
down to the wire play. Trail by 7 points and plenty of time left.
Bit of nail biting there from Steve Breeny.
I don't think there'll be much left there, would there?
Not many coaches have.
Claxton, as I mentioned before, the Rollers only lost one home game. They're here for about a number four in the next four games. Very proud of their home court record, and it becomes such a vital thing of trying to make that top eight, that home court advantage.
Well, especially tonight, we're here down the line with Newcastle. We're 18 points up over Perth, and they're the real danger team that can really put the Rollers out. So it'll be interesting. They need it, and they should be aware of that. And if there's any need for that extra desperation in their game, that is it, to get back into that top eight.
They'll go down fighting the Gold Coast Rollers up against the championship leaders, the North Melbourne Giants. Need to force some turnovers, the Rollers, if possible. Johnson cutting to the basket. Leader, plenty of experience in this North Melbourne Giants camp. That may help in the run down to the wire. And speaking of experience, Sangstrom comes up with a basket. Tonight for Larry Sangstock. He needs just one more for 5,000 points. Peter Hill for three. Airball.
Well, no need to take that shot, Terry. Still 15 seconds on the shot clock. Desperation, panic. I know they're down. They need to get a shot away. But that wasn't the right one. He was off balance then. Should have just kicked it on once more and got a better shot away. Great defense from North Melbourne. That was desperation. They were everywhere. Oh.
Wayward pass. Darryl McDonald, too happy, is a player who obviously prides himself on being immaculate. Very rare blemish on his game tonight, though, Kevin.
Yeah, but he's had a great game, and the battle between these two, Lafleur and him, has been well worth admission money. Not looking good now for the Rollers, though, too.
Mitchell, desperation, 3 points tonight. Big play, they're still in this game.
That's an intentional play. See, the thing against the Rollers team, they only had 13 fouls. They're trying to get into a situation where they can send them to the line, but they're sending Barry Sandstock to the line now. An intentional play, so they get two shots and possession back. So not the smartest play of all on Dean Brose's part.
Larry Sandstock will go to the line for the North Melbourne Giants. If he can make this basket, that'll make it. Ricky does, and that's 5,000 points in the NBL for Larry Sangstock. What a magnificent achievement. Congratulations, Larry Sangstock. I'll make it 5,001.
So 5,000 looks a lot better.
And how fitting he should make it. And the court where he played so many games for the Gold Coast Rollers. Tonight for the North Melbourne Giants. We're inside the final minute of this game. 52 seconds left. Donald. Foul on Andre Lafleur.
That's his sixth.
And that will put him out of the game, Brian Curl. Six fouls and take no further part. He sits down reluctantly.
And he's not happy with Peter Hill because he knows he's on fire. Peter Hill's the one that should have fouled him. But Peter Hill didn't realise it. So Andre Lafleur is out of the game. Not just going to make too much difference because 7 points, 42 seconds. I know it's happened before, but you've got a player out there with like Darryl McDonald taking control. There's no way that North Melbourne should lose this game. But Peter Hill was the one that should have fouled.
McDonald, it's a shame to see Andre leave the court before the end of the game because he's played so well. Peacock, D'Ambrose was trying to get the ball to Hill. Hill to Mitchell. Mitchell, can he make it two in a row? Can't do so. Now the Giants doing it easily. They've cracked the century barrier. 100 points for the North Melbourne Giants. 91 the Rollers.
Very impressive to play by the North Melbourne Giants tonight. That's why they're the number one team. And like I said, they've got a lot of experience and a good blend of youth out there. And when you've got players like Maley and Reece coming off the bench, scoring in double figures for you, that's a real bonus.
Hill for a massive three. Oh, so close. 26. The call from Brett Brown is go to work. Ambrosius gives Johnson a bit of a shove. Won't worry, Rod Johnson. They're going to celebrate tonight a victory here. Their first win here since 1990, Brian Curl. So they've absolutely busted open that hoodoo here at the Carrara Sporting Complex. The North Melbourne Giants. In an impressive display, Johnson just turning the screws into the Gold Coast Rollers now. 11 points for Johnson tonight. Harvey for three, can't do it. Follows up the shot. 17 seconds left. The Giants now starting to enjoy themselves. It's been a tough night at the office for them, though.
Yes, it hasn't been easy. The Rollers, they've hung in there, and but they just lacked somebody coming off the bench and giving them that lift. That's what they've really lacked. Their scoring's been really centred around Hill and Lafleur and Mitchell, and D'Ambrose chimed in with 10, but nobody's really given that big lift off the bench at all, and that's where they've really been let down tonight. But the other big telling factor, as we'll see later on, 45 rebounds for the North Melbourne Giants to 24 for the Gold Coast Rollers.
Sangstock for 3 points, a novelty! A novelty for Larry Sangstock at the top of the keyway. He'll celebrate his 5,000 point milestone. What a big effort. High fives all around for Larry Sangstock. He's really layering up now. Shooting the ball from three-point range. And I think he really, really did enjoy that. So makes it 5,000 and 3 career points, Larry Sangstock. What a tremendous effort for him against his old side. The North Melbourne Giants, 107. The Gold Coast Rollers, 91. It was oh so close for so long. But in the end, the North Melbourne Giants proving they are the championship leaders, showing you why they are the championship leaders. An absolutely tremendous effort. Larry Sangstock really did lead from the front tonight, and now he's with his ex-coach, Brian Curl.
Well, congratulations, Larry. Great game. You told me before the game you're going to take a three-pointer and make it.
It's hard to be practicing a lot. You know, it took me that leniency these days to shoot it from out there. You never did, mate, but I made one, Steve.
Well, I'm glad to see you make one. 5,000 points tonight. Congratulations for that. You know, I cheated you tonight. I only gave you three Olympics. I was corrected by Terry that you had four. But you've been great. This year, you seem to have found an extra leg or an extra arm, something out there.
Yeah, I think it's just the confidence that Brett gives the whole team. You know, I think that with D-Mac out there handling the ball and handing it out to all the guys, I think... And Brett giving me the starting role and the chance to play without knowing I'm going to be dragged if I do something wrong. And, you know, everyone's got that lens and everyone gets the confidence to play.
Well, I think the good thing about the team is the fact you've got a lot of experience out there and then you've got young players. And I thought tonight the big bonus for you was the lift that Paul Reece and Paul Maley gave you from the bench.
Yeah, well, Paul Maley especially came on, shot the threes. You know, that's great because that means he's back. And Paul Reece has been doing that every game. He comes in after me. The first thing he always does is grabs an offensive rebound, sticks it back in, gives us a lift, and he did that lots of times tonight and really helped us. So, yeah, I think it's a credit to our guys. Everyone's playing real well, and the old guys aren't dead yet.
Well, congratulations. We can see why North Melbourne are number one, and keep practicing those three-pointers, Larry, because I think it'll be a while before we see another one.
No. That's my couple for the year already. Thanks, mate.
That is exactly right, Larry Sangstock. That was his second three-pointer for the night, or for the season in 1994. What a great career he's had, and what a great victory. The North Melbourne Giants, 107 over the Gold Coast Rollers, 91. Welcome back to Carrara, where the North Melbourne Giants, the championship leaders, have broken a four-year losing hoodoo here at the Carrara Sporting Complex. And Brian Curl, they did it in fine fashion.
They certainly did, and they showed why they're number one team in the league at the moment. Gold Coast Rollers, Terry, not enough contributors. They really, some of their bench players really let them down. A lot was left to Hill, Mike Mitchell, and also Andre Lafleur, but nobody from the bench really gave them a lift.
The Gold Coast Rollers did try awfully hard, and not too much separated them on the field goal shooting percentages.
No, you look there at just that one percentage there to the Giants. Free throws, 83% of the Rollers. Poor shooting from the Giants. Three-point shooting. We saw some great three-point shooting there from the Rollers in Peter Hill and Andre Lafleur. Have a look at the rebounding there. Nearly double in the rebounding. And that is the telling stat of the whole game. You can forget about all the others. When you control the boards like that, you'll control any game.
So the North Melbourne Giants controlling the ball in great fashion. Andre Lafleur did awfully well out there tonight in a losing side, 22 points. Peter Hill was magnificent from outside for 20. Mitchell, 20 points also for the North Melbourne Giants. Paul Reece, what a magnificent job off the bench for 20 points. Larry Sengstock breaking the 5,000-point milestone with 16, and he enjoyed every one of those 16 points.
He certainly did, and that big three-pointer. He reckons in the interview that or after it, they never gave him the leniency to take them. But there was good all-round scoring there from the Giants. And you look at McDonald, 13, Johnson, 13. And also Paul Maley gave him a big lift from the bench.
So plenty of firepower there for the North Melbourne Giants, and they all came to the fore. The basketball action continues on Network 10 throughout the weekend. Please don't forget to join Billy Woods and Steve Carfino on Saturday for all the basketball action from the NBA and NBL action. Saturdays, 12 noon to 2 p.m. It continues on Sunday, a comprehensive review of the weekend in basketball, also with Billy Woods and Steve Carfino, Sunday, 12 noon to 2:30. Also, rugby action on Network 10 throughout the weekend. Queensland v New South Wales. The interstate rivalry will be fierce when they do battle at Ballymore. Please check your local guides for details. It should be an absolutely sensational match. From Brian Curl and myself, the North Melbourne Giants getting home here. I hope you enjoyed the match.
This program was proudly brought to you by Mitsubishi, Nintendo, McDonald's, and Reebok.